Hey guys, today I brought you shopping with me. We are at Costco and I want to show you how to shop clean for low carb anti-inflammatory ingredients, how to read behind the label. I get a lot of people telling me, do you have a shopping list for Costco that, so I know what I can buy over there? So I thought that the best idea is to bring you with me so I can show you how to read the labels and what I usually buy at Costco. And if you don't have a Costco where you live, don't worry, because these items, you can find them also online or probably locally at your store as well. So I hope this is helpful. This is gonna stock your pantry, refrigerator and freezer for success. Okay, so follow me and let's go shopping. Today I'm not gonna go through every single item at Costco. I'm just gonna go through the most common items for a low carb diet, the ones that can create confusion and the ones that are clean. And I have a lot of people telling me, Elena, after I learn with you and I go shopping, I have your little voice telling me, Elena's approved, Elena's not approved. So I'm gonna be telling you what is approved, what is clean, and what is not when we check those items. And of course, this is a Costco in Hawaii, and I'm not talking about prices, because items are, prices are different depending on where the Costco is. So here everything is a little bit more pricey. So today it is all about quality, not about how much. So I'm gonna talk more about packaged items, but when you are in the produce section, where we have to spend the most of the time in a supermarket, you wanna look for always organic and local, then organic, and then the rest. So that is the order, how you want to buy your vegetables and your fruit. In this section, I bought some local organic cucumbers. It's a must to buy organic cucumbers. Organic ginger, some local Hawaiian zucchini, some organic green beans, organic spinach. I like to buy the rest of my green leafies in another supermarket. And then my husband, whenever he has a sweet tooth for a higher carb, he's into apples. So I got some organic apples. Fernando, pick avocados. Avocados are my favorite fruit, low carb, high fat fruit. Is also really rich in amino acids that are building protein in the body. So complete protein and a very, very healthy fat to add to your diet. And avocados is in the list of the fruits that is not a must to buy organic. So this is for the dairy lovers, the cheese lovers. So on an anti-inflammatory diet, dairy is a big no, because casein can cause a lot of gastrointestinal distress. However, if you want to choose cheese, how you choose it? So this is a very good example. So what organic means is that whatever they were fed on wasn't treated with pesticides. But what we always have to look for a source of a cow-derived product is pasture-raised or grass-fed. So this is an organic cheese from pasture-raised cows. So this is Elena's approved. In Europe, they don't have the GMO law, so it's safest always to go for European cheese. Like, for example, I'm from Spain, so I have to, of course, tell you to get Manchego cheese, because you are gonna love it. And it's non-GMO, and it's from sheep. It's not from cow. It's really, really good. So what is an example of a cheese that is not approved? So here we have goat cheese. Creamy. When we look at the ingredients label, we see pasture, goat's milk, salt, and enzymes. So it looks like pretty clean, but then let me ask you something. Do we see on any of these labels that is pasture-raised, grass-fed, or free-range? No. So that means the way those animals were treated and fed is wrong. So this cheese is not approved. Oh, so here is one of my favorite ones. And a good example of a good cheese is the Kerrygold cheese. And why is also good? What do we see there? Grass-fed cows. So this is a really good cheese to get if you are a cheese lover. Actually, I forgot to mention, I'm not here also to talk about macros. I don't calculate or count macros for how many carbs, fat, and protein, because there are so many things that are supposed to be keto and low carb and grain free, and just because they claim to be low carb, they, it doesn't mean it's clean. So what I'm here to show you is how to read a label so you know if it's clean or not. So actually these cheese wraps, they became very popular now. It says that they are from cows non-treated with hormones and antibiotics. And it's a really good option for low carb wraps if you still eat dairy. If you are on a pure anti-inflammatory diet, no dairy, remember. However, when we look at the label, even if it's just pasteurized cow's milk, salt, and enzymes, I don't really see anywhere on the label what these cows were eating. I don't know if they were grass-fed or pasteurized. So, in my opinion, I couldn't buy them. We are in the world of the sausages right now. My husband, who is shopping with me over there, loves sausages. And I always say, whenever you want to heal, you want to stick to a real whole foods. And we don't see a sausage that walks around, right? That is already very processed. So I wouldn't go for sausages, but there are some options that I want to show you. There is one of those days that you want to eat a sausage worth to buy. So there is actually this package that says paleo, also keto-friendly, says somewhere. And it says it's organic. And when we look at the ingredients label, organic chicken, organic basil, everything organic, garlic, onion, garlic powder, salt, vinegar, black pepper, oregano, and calcium alginate casein, which is the part that I like the least, because this is an additive to preserve it. However, do we see on this label anywhere that this chicken is free range? No. Or pasture raised? No. So even if it looks organic and beautiful for paleo or keto friendly, it's not a good choice. But of course, compared to many other sausages that are here that have a lot of hormones, antibiotics, additives, nitrates, this is not a bad choice if you have a once in a while day that you want to eat sausage.
Ooh, oh. I like this. What's this? That reminds me of my type.
Oh, yeah. This is something that my husband loves. I only buy it for whenever he has a craving, because it's a really good substitute, kind of like for a jerky, a dry meat that you can take anywhere as a snack. And he's a hiker, so this snack keeps him up. It says it's keto friendly because it's high fat, low carb, of course, grain free. It says no added hormones and antibiotics. I don't like it 100% because it doesn't say it's grass fed or pasture raised. But as I said, for once in a while, not totally bad. But it says beef, salt, celery powder, vinegar, garlic, and natural flavor. So this is the trick. Anything that has celery powder on the label, that is equal nitrates. So even if it says no added nitrates, this already has nitrates. Celery powder is the way they have to add nitrates. So when you find jerky, bacon, sausages, anything with celery powder, don't buy it. That is equal nitrates. Actually, I like these sausages. It's a better approach for sausages. They still have some celery powder, but as I said, if you want sausages once in a while, I recommend not to eat sausage, but if you want them once in a while, this is a better choice because it's from 100% grass-fed cow. So no hormone, antibiotic, grass-fed. This is a much better choice. I love smoked salmon. It's great for breakfast or to put it on top of your grain-free toast, but it's very hard to find a very good smoked salmon at Costco. When we look at the Kirkland brand, what we always have to look for is wild Alaskan salmon. Always wild Alaskan, has to be wild cut, not farm. But when we look at the ingredients label, let's see what we have. We have salmon, salt, sugar, and wood smoke. This item already has sugar, and one of the main homeworks when you go shopping is to avoid any added sugar on the labels. So this would be a no because of the added sugar. Always look for a smoked salmon without sugar. And this one, it doesn't say anywhere is wildcat. Oh no, this says clearly fish farms. So since it's not a wildcat smoked salmon, this is also a no. This is another item became really popular for grain-free options for wraps. And let's see what this wrap has. It looks like it's paleo and keto friendly, so it's good for grain-free options. And we look at the ingredients label, what we have is cage-free egg whites, cage-free whole egg, cauliflower, olive oil, salt, xanthan gum, which is good. It's a natural gum from fermentations of sugars, spices, and citric acid. So because I'm really picky with labels, you know how picky I am with labels. If you are in a rush and you want to have an option, you are camping, you go somewhere and you want to take some wraps, this is okay. However, these eggs in here are not from a pasture-raised or free-range chicken. It doesn't say anywhere. So ideally, this is not 100% clean. And remember, you can check the link in the description of the video how to make your own tortillas. I have a video already about that and it's really simple. These ones are not 100% clean. Another very good example for convenience. I have a lot of clients telling me, I really like to buy the egg whites from Costco because it's convenient. You just put it in the microwave and you eat it. And this is basically what it says, is cheese, bacon, and eggs. So based on this, it would be perfect for a low carb alternative muffin. But when we look at the ingredients label, let's see what we have. So it contains cheese, which is not grass-fed or pasture-raised, tons of cheese. It has bacon in there with celery powder, and celery powder is nitrate. Natural flavors, which we don't even know what is that. And we have, of course, eggs, and this is not a free-range chicken. So this is not 100% clean either. And actually, what I've seen on this option is even worse, because this option has canola oil, and canola oil is a trans fat. It's a refined oil that is refined with petroleum. So what about the meat here? So there is no chicken, beef, bison or pork that I have found in here that is grass-fed or pasture-raised or free-range. That's what we have to look for. Organic only means that those animals were fed with corn that didn't have pesticides, but can be still fed with genetically modified corn. And as you can see here, we don't even see any no-hormones, no antibiotics. So the meat in here is not the best. And for low-carb fruits alternatives, I love to buy frozen blueberries or raspberries or strawberries. But what we have to look for always, always for this kind of fruits, organic, because otherwise blueberries have tons of pesticides. And this is a very good example of what not to buy. Acai is a superfruit and it's supposed to be low carb like blueberries, like very, very healthy. But actually this is not pure acai, because when we look at the ingredients label, what it is here, look all this. It has acai puree, but then they add cane sugar and they add sunflower lecithin and citric acid preservative. So this is not just acai. When you want to buy acai, be sure that you only find this on the ingredients label. So do you see all of this? So this is just an example of processed food. When we are on an anti-inflammatory diet, we have to stick to the real food, whatever is coming from the ground, whatever is coming from the ocean. We don't see food like this coming from the ground or the ocean. That means it's already processed. So that causes a lot of inflammation. So all of this, big no. So I usually buy fish in the frozen section because the most important thing that we have to find on the label when we buy fish is wildcat, never farm fish, and it has to be from low mercury fish. The bigger the fish, the longer the life, the more mercury contamination. So focus on the smaller fish and always wild cut. Like for example, this cod is just cod and is wild Alaskan. Be careful with kombucha because this is a fermentation with a yeast. If you have candida overgrowth, I don't recommend to drink kombucha. But also look at that label in there. Look at that label. It has 20 grams of carbohydrates in there. 20 grams, which means it's tons of added sugar. So 20 grams is 5 teaspoons of sugar. Would you ever eat 5 teaspoons of sugar like this from a package? No, right? So why do we drink it in a different form? So all these juices, kombuchas, drink like that, the main danger is all the sugar that they carry in there. That is the same as a can of soda. On an anti-inflammatory diet, we're not doing dairy. But if you are incorporating any form of butter in your diet, like for example, my husband loves his butter. I don't eat butter, but I tell you why I buy my butter. So this is a really good option that you can find here at Costco for butter, which is the Kerrygold Irish butter, because it's grass-fed, and that is what we have to look for on the label. So it's a really good option if you want to eat a good source of butter, or the way I use it for an anti-inflammatory approach is using the butter to make ghee. Ghee is a clarified butter without the milk solids. So for $10, you can make almost like a 32 ounces mason jar of ghee. But actually, they have listened to my prayers for a very long time. I've been asking to bring the unsalty form of Kerrygold, which I prefer much better to make ghee. The silver color is unsalty, the gold is salty, and it's still grass-fed. They listen to my prayers. But here we have a very good example of a butter that you don't want to buy because it's organic, but it's not grass-fed or pasture-raised. Be careful with vegan options for butter, and this is a very good example because it's a beautiful package that says plant-based butter made with olive oil, so it's dairy-free. However, when we look at the ingredients label, let's see if it's just olive oil. We see soybean oil, palm oil. These two oils are refined with petroleum. They are trans fat. They cause a lot of inflammation in your body. It has lactic acid. EDTA is a very dangerous additive. It has a lot of additives and preservatives. That the most dangerous part of vegan butters is the oil. So not soybean oil, canola, safflower, sunflower, palm oil. Those are trans fats. Don't check this label. This is just to sell you the product. Always the ingredients label. Ooh, look at this, look at this. Yeah, this is a good example of goods and bads. So now the word keto is very popular, right? For grain-free and low carb. But then when we look at the label, not everything is that good. So let's look at this granola, which I know my husband loves. He loves this granola, and actually for him that he eats butter is a good choice. So when we see is keto, blueberry, cinnamon, grain-free, non-GMO, which is important, no sugar, protein and healthy fats. So let's see how clean it is. So when we look at the ingredients label, we see sunflower seeds, pumpkin seeds, coconut chips, almonds, pecans, blueberry, cinnamon, butter, and salt. And it has as sweeteners erythritol and monk fruit, which are two sweeteners that are zero glycemic index. So this, because he loves granola, and he cannot wait until I make the granola that is clean. So then I buy this one for you. But why I think it's not 100% clean. This is a good alternative that is much cleaner than many other granolas. But why is not 100% clean on an anti-inflammatory diet? First, we don't digest sugar alcohols, and this one has erythritol. So when we don't digest sugar alcohol, that causes more fermentation, can cause more yeast overgrowth if you have candida, if you have also SIBO, small intestine bacteria overgrowth, it's gonna cause even more fermentation and more overgrowth. So it's why a lot of people don't feel really good when they eat sugar alcohol. So this one has sugar alcohols on the label. And if you really want to look behind the label, the butter that is added here is not grass-fed or pasture-raised. So that is why this is not 100% clean. But for my husband, this is a really good breakfast. So it's gonna go in our cart. Pancakes. This is also a really good alternative for breakfast. And in my first book, I have a really good option for how to make your low-carb, grain-free pancakes that are 100% clean. But if you don't want to make them, then you can try to find a pancake mix that is okay. Actually, this brand used to make a pancake mix that it was paleo-friendly, so it's grain-free but a little bit higher in carbs. But let's see, this is the first time that I see that says keto-friendly. So let's see what the ingredients say. So it has almond flour, eggs, tiger nut flour. This is good. This is the difference with the paleo. The tiger nut flour is a resistant starch that doesn't spike your insulin levels. Coconut flour, cassava flour, buttermilk with baking soda, salt, and spices. So this is a pretty clean alternative. Of course, the eggs are not pasture-raised or free-range, so that is how we read behind the labels. But if you don't want to make your own pancakes, this can be a good, okay, pancake mix. And this is another example of a low-carb, grain-free snack. There are so many keto snacks right now at the market, but a lot of them are not clean. So this is based on coconut, which coconut is one of the best low-carb fruits, really rich in caprylic acid, lauric acid, which is antifungal. So let's see, based on this, looks pretty good because everything is organic and it has nuts and seeds. So let's see when we look at the ingredients label. So it's good, organic, non-GMO, zero trans fats. That looks good so far. Then when we look at the ingredients label, we see coconut, pumpkin seeds, pecans, almonds. They add cane sugar and they add rice syrup. So how can they claim that this is keto? Because you have some two added sugars in there. They add sugar alcohols, which bother the digestive system, coconut butter, flax seeds, and then another added sugar is agave. So yeah, definitely this has four different types of sweeteners and three of them are high carb and they cause a lot of microbial imbalance in your gut. So it's a no. Oh yeah, for the peanut butter cup lovers, this is a good one. So let's see what we find here because it says coconut oil, MCT, which is medium chain triglycerides, is usually isolated from coconut and is a type of fat that our body is using as a fuel. So let's see what we find on the ingredients label. We have two kinds. We have dark chocolate or dark chocolate peanut butter. So the dark chocolate has chocolate liquor, erythritol, which is sugar alcohol. We said we better on an anti-inflammatory diet avoid sugar alcohols. Coconut oil, coconut butter, inulin is an added sugar, cacao powder, which is processed with alkali. So you don't want to buy any cacao butter that says alkali because that means it's already processed and they remove some of the nutrients from cacao. And then stevia. And the other one, the same thing. So this is not really 100% clean. For whenever you have a craving, it's not completely bad, so I would say it's an intermediate one whenever you are craving for a sweet, you don't want to bake, and then you want to have a treat, but not for an everyday thing. Mayo. Mayo is something that people on low-carb diets, high-fat diets use a lot to add extra fat into your meals, and there is nothing wrong with mayo if mayo is clean. When my mother used to make mayo, told me you cannot keep it on the refrigerator for more than 3 days because you have a high risk of getting salmonella because mayo is a raw egg. So a mayo that stays on a shelf or a refrigerator for months is not real mayo. That's point number one. But also, if we look at the ingredient label of this mayo, we see the first run item is soybean oil, which is one of the oils that are refined, distilled with petroleum, and is a trans fat, so you don't want to eat this mayo. Plus, they add sugar on it and juice concentrate, which is another way to add sugar. So this mayo is not real mayo and it's full of a lot of bad ingredients. So this is a big no. So look at the beauties in here, fat. We do need fat in our body for absorbing vitamins and minerals in our gut, for producing hormones, because the precursor of hormones is cholesterol, for keeping the cell membrane of every single of our tissues healthy. So look at all this beauty, but not all the oils are made equal. So I want to show you how to choose oil. So actually I want to show you this beauty, which is new here in Hawaii. It's a Hawaiian macadamia oil. A macadamia oil has a high smoke point. The only ingredient is macadamia. So it looked like a pretty one that at some point we are gonna have to try. But then let's see what we have to look for when we buy olive oil. Mostly at home what we eat is avocado oil, olive oil, ghee that I make with the grass-fed butter, or coconut oil or MCT oil. So when we buy oil, so what you have to look for on the label is that it says extra virgin or virgin, cold pressed or first pressed, that is the most important, so you know how the oil has been isolated, and organic for olives. Olives is a must to be organic. So this one is non-organic. They used to have one that is organic, extra virgin. I don't find it. They don't have it today. Well, they don't have it, and olive oil is a must to be organic. So today we are not buying olive oil. So what about avocado oil at Costco? Here in Hawaii, we only have one brand, which is The Chosen Foods. I know in other states they have Marian. Marian is a really good avocado oil, but we only have this one. And why I wouldn't buy this one is because, let me find. So this oil used to say cold pressed, but now it doesn't say cold pressed anywhere. So I contacted the company and they told me that now they don't do cold pressed anymore. They do expeller pressed, and you don't want to buy any expeller pressed oil. So if you don't find cold pressed or first pressed avocado oil, don't buy it. The other two that you can find, and we like it at home, is ghee. And actually this ghee is good because it's a grass-fed ghee. And it doesn't have, it's just unsalted grass-fed butter. So this is a perfect ghee. But if you look at the price of this is almost $30. And with this, which is $10, you can make the same amount. So it's just so simple. And the other one that we buy is coconut oil. What you have to look for when you buy coconut oil is extra virgin or virgin, unrefined, cold pressed coconut oil. Coconut is not a must to be organic. It's one of those fruits that doesn't have to be organic, but this one is organic. So this coconut oil has everything. So for spices, of course, spices are low carb, but when you buy spices, they have to be organic and in a glass container, and all of these are plastic, so no. And then when we buy vinegar, balsamic is okay, you don't have any yeast overgrowth, but the one that I recommend to buy, organic, raw, unfiltered apple cider vinegar. You have the mother right there. So this vinegar doesn't cause any yeast overgrowth, bacteria overgrowth. If you suffer from histamine intolerance, this is the vinegar, the only vinegar that you can have once in a while. And the other vinegar that a lot of people buy because it's cheap, This vinegar, I only use it for cleaning. This vinegar is what we use for cleaning products, but not for ingesting. Only raw apple cider vinegar. The tomato sauce for your low-carb pasta, for whatever you are doing. On an anti-inflammatory diet, I always say that we have to prevent eating tomatoes because tomatoes are nightshades and they can cause more gastrointestinal inflammation. But if anybody at home wants to eat some tomato sauce, there are a lot of tomato sauce in here. But what you have to look for first, that is organic, because those vegetables and tomatoes have to be organic. And then when we look at the ingredient label of this one, organic tomatoes, organic onions, extra virgin olive oil, organic basil, organic garlic, salt and black pepper. So this looks pretty clean to me. Ooh, olives. I'm from Spain. I love olives. We have all kind of olives in there. So my husband also loves olives, and especially these ones. No, it's not these ones, actually. The last ones that
those
we
are
bought.
The bad ones.
Those are the bad ones. Yeah, the ones that we bought last time, they had jalapeno and garlic on it, and the ingredient label was really clean. You are right. But these ones, let's see what it says here. It says olives, water, minced pimiento, that's pepper, salt. It has lactic acid, sodium alginate, calcium chloride, potassium sorbate. It's too many preservatives for olives. So these ones actually are not clean. Sorry, they don't have the garlic jalapeño today. But they have these ones that are clean, which is Kalamata olives. So it's organic, it's important for olives. Kalamata olives, they are organic. And then the ingredients is just olives, water, salt, organic vinegar and extra virgin olive oil. These are beautifully clean. So these are gonna go home. All right, so this is a very good alternative, convenient way to add protein and healthy fats to your diet. I love sardines, and there is people that they don't like sardines, but sardines are a really good source of omega-3 fatty acids and a lot of calcium, actually. So this is really good to put it in your diet. But when we buy salmon, sardines, chicken on a can, what do you have to look for? Here we have the example for one of my favorite brands of sardines, each season. So first, they are wild cut. That's what we have to look for. And then second, look at the labels here. So it's non-GMO, but the most important is that the can is BPA free. BPA is an endocrine system disruptor. It's a very dangerous toxin that causes, it's a trigger for a lot of hormonal imbalances. So it's in cans and plastic. So when we buy something on a can, we want to look for BPA free. So this is a really good source of sardines. And these sardines are in olive oil, which is a very good healthy fat. Also wild Pacific sardines, Wild Planet, it doesn't say that it's BPA free, but when you go to the website, it says that all the products that they have are on BPA free cans. So these are also wild cut, so a go-to. Look at all that spam. They call Hawaii the spam state. They love spam. But actually, spam is really high in trans fats and fats that raise the risk of coronary heart disease. So it shouldn't be in your diet. Here we have the good ones. These are your favorite garlic jalapeno, right? The ingredients is olives, jalapeno peppers, garlic, water, vinegar, salt, and herbs. So this is a good one. So let's get some dairy-free milk. I like making my own milk, but my husband is the convenience person in the house. So this almond milk actually is good. Almonds is organic, is unsweetened. It's heavy also. Let's look at the ingredient label. Contains almonds. Here. So water, almonds, vanilla, gum, a lot of vitamins, vitamin A, E, D2, B2, B12. This is quite like a pretty clean nut milk compared to many others that have carrageenan. Be careful with carrageenan, which is just to thicken the milks and it's carcinogenic. So this one is a good option. Coffee, for your bulletproof coffee. Coffee, if you decide to buy coffee, has to be always organic, because coffee is one of the most sprayed plants with pesticides. I love baking. You know, it's my weakness. It's why I bring you recipes almost every week as well. So one of my favorite flours on a low carb diet is almond flour. It's one of the lowest in carbohydrates. And what you have to be sure when you buy almond flour is that it's blanched. Blanched doesn't have the skin, so it's very fine for baking, which I don't think we have. A very good alternative for a dairy-free creamer that you can put at your coffee. So when we look at the ingredients label, it's mostly coconut milk powder, which is a good option for low carb. Coconut sugar, which is increasing the carbs a little bit, but just by 1 gram to 2 grams. And then it has some extra virgin coconut oil. So this is perfect to make your dairy-free bullet coffee. So more than a coffee lover, I'm a tea lover, and I do love matcha. Matcha is a powerhouse of antioxidants. It's boosting your metabolism, full of polyphenols. Costco has this matcha powder, which the only ingredient is just matcha. As you can see, ideally matcha has to be organic, that would be best. And then actually we have these tea bags that are organic, and it's just matcha. So this is also a really, really good alternative for coffee. Hey, the danger of the sweeteners is here for low carb approach. So stevia and monk fruit are usually the best because they have zero glycemic index. However, you have to be sure that the only ingredient that you see on the ingredients label is stevia or monk fruit. All of these ones that are very common brands, they are mixed with sugar alcohols. And for example, this is mostly erythritol. The stevia or monk fruit are usually very small packages because they are very concentrated. So when you buy find stevia or monk fruit in bulk like this, it's because it's a sugar alcohol. And sugar alcohols, we said, they are not good on an anti-inflammatory diet. So all of this is a no. These are my favorite plant-based proteins on a low-carb diet. We have hemp hearts, hemp seeds in here, and we have chia seeds. They are both just one ingredient, hemp seeds and chia. And what is the beauty about these two is that they are really high in protein, but they are also really high in omegas, in omega-3 fatty acids, which are anti-inflammatory. 4 tablespoons of chia is the equivalent to 1 steak. So not only eating animal protein is the only source of protein. This is a really good plant-based protein. And before I forget, why these ones are good is because they are organic. Chia and hemp seeds, they have to be organic. Look at this beauty that is new here at Costco. This is coconut manna, or what is called coconut butter. I really like the brand Nutiva. I was so happy to see this. It's the same price than online stores. So this is just basically organic whole coconut puree. And it's a really good thing to cook with, to make your frosting when you are baking. It's awesome. So let's talk about nut butter. We like to eat nut butters also as a very good natural healthy fat and healthy protein. And it's a plant-based protein. So what we have here, I love nutso. Nutso is a blend of nuts and seeds, like for example, chia seeds, flax seeds that are really good in fiber. So this is adding fiber, omega-3 fatty acids, protein. It has cashews, almonds, Brazil nuts, hazelnuts, pumpkin seeds, and salt. And they are all dry roasted, which is the other important thing that we need to look for on the label. Don't buy raw nuts. By dry roasted nut butter. So this is okay. And cashews increase the amount of carbohydrates a little bit compared to the rest of the nuts. Cashews are higher in carbohydrates, so it's why it says it's a paleo alternative, but this is not too bad. Otherwise, instead of this, we can go more specific just with almond butter. So almond is a really good low carb, high fat nut. And the ideal is that it's roasted. As I said, we always have to look for roasted almonds. Roasting your nuts eliminates phytic acid and make it more digestible. So we are lucky that the ones that we find at Costco are already roasted. And for the peanut butter lovers, there are two options here. Whew, this is heavy. So let's start with this one. So actually this one that is kind of like, it's more or less the same price, $10 both, but this one is roasted peanuts, but it has sugar and it has soybean oil, rapeseed oil. They are roasted with trans fats, with refined oil. So this is not a good choice for peanut butter. However, this one is good because the nuts are organic. They are dry roasted and salt. So those are the only ingredients in there. So this peanut butter is a good option if you want to buy peanut butter. However, why I don't usually recommend peanuts on an anti-inflammatory diet is because peanuts are the nuts that cause the most of the inflammation in the body. They cause a lot of fermentation and they can cause more yeast overgrowth. And why is that? So peanuts grow an aflatoxin that is coming from a fungus. So when we put it in, it's causing more yeast overgrowth in our gut. But if you wanna choose some peanut butter, this is a good choice. Of course, nuts is one of the best also plant-based proteins to add to your low-carb high-fat diet. Almonds, pecans, walnuts, macadamias are my favorite. And here in Hawaii, we have very good macadamia. And this one, actually, I think it's gonna go home. The good thing about this is that they are already dry roasted, no any other oil. So these are going home. Look at this. This is new. Because usually coconut chips, they are coming with a lot of sugar, but let's see this, I haven't seen this before. It says organic coconut, the best low carb fruit. So when we look at the ingredients label, it's just organic coconut, can you believe that? This is usually mixed with tons of refined sugars and oil. So I think this is gonna go home too. It's a very good snack to take everywhere. We are good for today, right? What do you think? We are tired already, so I think we are going to leave for another video the granola bars and the protein powder. We can just make a video by itself. I hope this was helpful. If you like this video, remember to subscribe to my channel, click the bell button to get weekly notifications with more healthy tips, and I hope to see you in the next video.